Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thanks for being here. It's nice to see all of you this morning. Today is the fourth Sunday in Advent, December 20th, 2020 service for First Congregational United Church of Christ in Zumbrota. Before we start our service, does anyone have any announcements that they'd like to make at this time? Seeing and hearing none, I have some announcements that I'd like to make. We are overjoyed to be able to meet together on Christmas Eve at 4 o'clock. I have heard from most people about their attendance. If you haven't contacted me and you are planning on attending, we still have room for a few, I would say 4 or 5 people, other than everyone that I've heard from. So we still have room for 4 or 5 or so people. If you would like to attend, please let me know. And again, this is people that I haven't already heard from. Please let me know. You can call me on my cell phone or you can send me an email. And you can find that contact information on the website and let me know that you're going to be attending. I would appreciate that. The second announcement that I have is I draw your attention to the insert that we have and the notice regarding the Christmas Fund, Veterans of the Cross, and the Emergency Fund for the United Church of Christ. And I know that some of you have already made contributions to the Christmas Fund, and we really appreciate it. Christmas Fund has been caring for active and retired clergy and lay employees of the United Church of Christ for over 100 years, providing emergency grants, supplementation of small annuities and health premiums, and a Christmas thank you gift checks each December to some of the retired people who may not have a robust income. So if you were able to donate to that, I would please suggest that you do that. The annual meeting for First Congregational United Church of Christ is going to take place on January 31st after the service. The church council is working on a hybrid in-person or virtual meeting. We will give you more details as they become available to us. Dick Shearer contacted me this week and let me know that there was an article about Aging in Place for Farmers program that First Congregational is working on. There was an article in the Red Wing paper this week.
And Rochester.
And the Red Wing paper, as Dick told me, had an interesting position of articles because on one side of the paper, as I understand it, I haven't seen the issue yet, on one side of the paper was a couple of articles or an article about two churches in, I think, Hager City and Ellsworth, Wisconsin, that were being closed because of the small number of congregants that they had. And then next to this article about the two churches closing was the article about the aging in place. And Dick thought that I should know about that. comparison between those two. This congregation has been around for 150, 160 years. And I think that the article highlighted the fact that you don't need a lot of people in order to do God's work in the world. And that's a message for us to think about in the coming days. I'd like to thank Connie Wendt and your sister-in-law Barb. And did Billy help with the decorating the tree? It's gorgeous. And thank you so much for doing that. Would you please stand if you were able and bow your heads as I give the prayer of invocation. Jesus, we welcome the anniversary of your birth. Let us remember your humble birth and the great things that can happen from modest beginnings. Amen. Please join me in singing hymn 128, In the Bleak Midwinter.
Follow the plans you have designed for our lives.
Amen. Please be seated and join me in singing hymn 124, Away in a Manger. Fourth Sunday of Advent, the last Sunday before Christmas Eve. And so far, for every week we have lit a candle, and today is the fourth week, and we light the fourth Advent candle today. And it gives us an opportunity to think and to see the lights burning, and to anticipate the anniversary of Christ's birth. O God, we light the fourth candle of Advent.
We hear you, Angel Gabriel, and witness the Angel Mary. Fill us with your grace and light.
Let us focus on the stories. Mary's faith and her courage. Joseph's perseverance. And the joy that baby Jesus brought to the world.
Shine on us, O God of justice. Guide our path through gloom of night. And come to us, O Christ the light.
for our meditation today. If you wish, you can focus on the light, or you can close your eyes. But let's use this time to create space. To create space in our minds and in our lives where God can enter and be with us. Take some time and take a deep breath in and let that breath go out. And return here and let's listen for the Word of God today. The reading is from 2 Samuel chapter 7 verses 1 through 13. That can be found on page 245 of the Pew Bible. The title of this reading is God's Covenant with David. It's a fascinating look at gratitude and power. David wants to show his gratitude to God, and something kind of surprising happens. Now, when the king was settled in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his enemies around him, the king said to the prophet Nathan, "See, now I am living in a house of cedar, but the ark of God stays in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that same night, the word of the Lord came to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, are you the one to build me a house to live in? I have not lived in a house since the day I brought up the people of Israel from Egypt to this day, but I have been moving about in a tent and a tabernacle. Wherever I have moved about among all the people of Israel, Did I ever speak a word with any of the tribal leaders of Israel, whom I commanded to shepherd my people Israel, saying, why have you not built me a house of cedar? Now therefore, thus you shall say to my servant David, thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep, to be prince over my people Israel. And I have been with you wherever you went, and have cut off all your enemies from before you. And I will make for you a great name, like the name of the great ones of the earth. And I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them, so that they may live in their own place and be disturbed no more. And evildoers shall afflict them no more as formerly. From the time that I appointed judges over my people Israel, and I will give you rest from all your enemies. Moreover, the Lord declares to you that the Lord will make you a house. When your days are fulfilled and you lie down with your ancestors, I will raise up your offspring after you, who shall come forth from your body, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. Thus ends the reading. My sermon today is entitled Building a House. It's easy to understand David and what David wanted to do. Gratitude is a wonderful human emotion. David recognized all that God had done for David in David's life, raising David from a shepherd boy to be the king of Israel. And David wanted to do something for God, to show his gratitude. And God came to Nathan and said, that's not what I want. The time isn't right for that. He, verse 13, shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. I'm going to stop there and go backwards just a little bit. Many Christian scholars believe that Isaiah is writing about Christ. And in the reading from 2 Samuel, this is predicting the birth of Christ and Christ's life. And the Jews at that time do not believe that. They don't believe that this is about Jesus Christ, but this is about the Messiah who will come. So there is this schism. Let's explore if this passage is about Jesus. If Jesus is the Messiah, the Anointed One. And what the Messiah was going to do is that the Messiah is going to unify Israel, unify the 12 tribes, rebuild the temple, which had been demolished. Bring all the people home to Israel. So when that didn't happen in that manner, it's easy to see how some people thought, this person isn't the Messiah, because these things didn't happen. So, who was Jesus? Jesus wasn't a military ruler, wasn't a soldier. Jesus didn't have an army at his beck and call. Jesus didn't have a big house and an estate and grounds and employees. Jesus didn't have a church, a synagogue in which he preached. He didn't have possessions. So it's easy to understand how the Jewish people thought, this person isn't the Messiah. What does God mean then when God says, he shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever? Jesus didn't have a kingdom, didn't have a synagogue, didn't have a palace, didn't have any of these trappings. So what does this mean? What Jesus had was an idea. That's really what Jesus had. An idea. An idea about how people should live and what people should do one for the other. And what does a good relationship with God look like? And what does a good relationship with my neighbor look like? These are the things that Jesus addressed. These are the things that Jesus lived for. Relationship with God, with neighbor. And working for others. That's it. And so at Christmas, we recognize that Jesus wasn't a Messiah in the expected sense. Jesus' kingdom was relationship. That's it. Relationship with God and relationship with people. And living a life consistent with the force of those relationships. And if this reading from 2 Samuel is about Jesus, the throne of Jesus' kingdom, which will last forever, is that relationship. That's what it is. If a person travels, one of the things that person can do is go to Europe and Asia and Africa and look at huge temples, synagogues, cathedrals built to honor God and different ideas of God. Huge structures built in stone and steel that have lasted for hundreds, maybe thousands of years. But stone and steel will not last forever. We know that. But this idea of Jesus, that can last forever. It exists in our hearts. And it will last forever. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let's take a breath in and a breath out. And get ready to do our best on singing Hymn 125, Angels We Have Heard on High.
Yeah.
We have the opportunity now to talk about our concerns and our joys, the good and the bad as we live our lives. And if something has happened that you'd like us to talk about, please, please let's do that.
I have not found my dog, so I want to thank everybody for the concerns. It's been tough, but I haven't given up completely yet. Thank everybody. I want to thank everybody for this.
There's no reason to give up. Wonderful things happen this season. Thank you for all who helped Arlen look for Coco. Any other joys or concerns? Yes.
It's been a week of hospital support. Some of our family members, my sister-in-law had surgery in that one. Our daughter-in-law's father, Rich Shoes, ended up in the hospital with heart problems, and he ended up getting a pacemaker, so he had surgery, and he's home and doing okay. And I have another sister-in-law that I found out she had another detached retina and had surgery for that. And that's scary for her because it was the third time.
What is her name?
Carol.
I have firsthand experience with that. That's very unpleasant.
This last time it detached completely.
Does anyone else have anything they would like to say? Would you please bow your heads as I give the prayers of the people? God, on this beautiful and sunny day, here in Zumbrota, there's a little bit of snow on the ground. Just enough to make it pretty. And we who are here have so much to be thankful for. Beautiful world and beautiful friends. People who love us and care for us. And people for whom we care. We pray for all of our friends and neighbors who cannot be with us on Sunday mornings. We miss them, and one of the reasons we can keep going is that we know we'll be with them again. God, please strengthen those who suffer in silence. They do not need to do that. Everyone is loved. Everyone has people that care about them and want the best for them and are waiting for an opportunity to help. So if we have problems, if we have concerns, give us the strength to share. We are living through difficult times right now. The COVID-19 pandemic seems to be getting worse. Give us the strength to persevere and keep going and stay safe and do what we need to do for ourselves and for others. We have hope that things will be different and better. Please give your healing grace for Connie Hawley's father, for Judy Fredrickson, Carol, and Rich. Give them the ability to work hard at getting better. And give them hope for better days ahead. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to help 3 Zumbrota families this Christmas. We're also thankful for Linda and the music that we have at Christmas. We pray for the family of Gerald Kylo. And we pray for the safe return of Coco. We love others. And when we love others, let us have some happy endings, God, this season. We pray in gratitude for all of us who are doing our best in keeping the faith and being safe and keeping our concern for others at the front of our minds. Let us be resilient when things go bad and appreciative when things go well. And when we return to our world, when COVID is in the past, let's learn from this. Learn how much we mean to each other and the sacrifices that we can make as a people in order to have a good outcome for all. Please join me in praying the prayer that Jesus taught to his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let us greet each other. Stand if you are able and communicate how much love we have for each other and how much love there is in this building. Please join me in singing the peace song, which can be found on the inside back cover of the black hymnal.
Thank you.
seated for the offering. Before we sing our last hymn 126, Angels from the Realms of Glory, I want to say this, that I've got kind of an easy job, because when things don't go so well with a sermon or something else, I always have Linda to fall back on, and she'll pick up all the pieces, won't you? So, let's try to do her playing some honor. Hymn 126, Angels from the Realms of Glory. for my benediction. Let's do as Jesus taught us to do. Be concerned with our relationship with God and what God calls us to do in this world, and our relationship one with the other, and what that relationship calls us to do for our friends and our neighbors. Amen. Peace be with you.